Yes, a very good morning. Today you have two consecutive periods, 15 minutes break, and then the next class period, so accordingly join. Right? Anyhow. Chaliye, so we are starting this 10.5. And before that, I was telling you about very important theorem which are going to be applied to solve the questions of exercise 10.5. Right? So I was telling you how we can detect the angle described by an arc at a point on the circle. So I was telling you that if we are taking, but it's arc is a part of the boundary of the circle. This is a full arc, circular arc, right? When I take one of its part, that is regarded as an arc. If the Kirti must switch on your video only, then I can clear your query. JJ sisters, you also, because nowadays students, they are using the ID's name of their class mates. So better to switch on your video. Hanji Kirtima, what do you want to say?
Ma'am, please mic laga ho, voice kam aa rahi hai.
So this is totally a circle, and this is called circular arc. When we take some of the part of this arc, like I'm taking and I'm marking it to be PQ, then this is called minor arc, and the upper part is called major arc. If I want to see the angle subtended by this arc at any point inside, outside, or on the boundary of the circle, let us take a point P, and this arc angle is to be seen for this arc PQ. So I have started with the point P, go to this point P, and coming back to point Q. This will be the angle subtended by this arc at the point Q, T. So whenever, as we see the angle of the chord at a particular point, in the same way we can see angle of an arc on a particular point that I am telling you, right? So what is the main reason of understanding that how to detect the angle subtended by an arc at the circle? Because we are going to see a very important theorem without proof. Again, the proof is being deleted. Otherwise, when the proof was there, its proof was very, very important. But now we will do just the statement of the theorem. We will just learn that what is the application of this theorem. Shall we? Let us see. And the name of the theorem is Degree-Meyer theorem. What is the theorem I am telling you, and what is its use that the name itself is telling you? Name hi bata raha hai ki is theorem ka use hum kya karenge. Degree-Meyer theorem. That means theorem that we will use to measure the degree. Degree of what? Degree of angle. That means Degree-Meyer theorem is used to measure the different angles in the different figures, right? So this is its use. Let us see what is its statement. First of all, I'm writing the statement in case of minor arc. Angle subtended. चलो पहले मैं जर्नल में स्टेटमेंट करवाती हूँ फिर बात. Angle subtended by an arc of a circle at the center is double the angle subtended by it at a point on the remaining part of the circle. Angle subtended by an arc of a circle at a center is double the angle subtended by it at a point on the remaining part of the circle. Very long, you can say, statement. Ekdam se padho samajh nahi aati, and we are very much worried how is itni lengthy statement ko learn kaise karenge. No need to worry. We will try to learn this statement using the figure, then very easily we'll come to know what is the way to learn it. Angle subtended by an arc of a circle at the center is double the angle subtended by it at a point on the remaining part of the circle. Angle कौन subtend कर रहा है? Circle का arc. तो arc तो बहुत तरह के होते हैं circle के. If I'm considering the arc of the circle, this is the minor arc. Second case, this PRQ. This is the major arc. Major arc. And if this P and Q, they are coming as the end point of the center, a diameter, then this is the semicircular arc. Three type of arcs are there. One is the minor arc, PQ, this way. Another is the major arc, PRQ, this way. And third type of arc is semicircular arc, when the end point of the diameter, end point of the arc, it lies on the diameter. Then it is called semicircular arc. Now he says angle subtended by an arc of a circle. Konsa arc bhai? Minor, major, semicircular. It should be clear. That means theorem will be discussed differently for minor arc, for major arc, and for semicircular arc. तीन तरह से हम इस थ्योरम को डिस्कस करेंगे. Firstly, I am discussing the theorem in the case when the arc is minor. So first case, minor arc. Figure के साथ साथ statement को relate करेंगे. एक मिनट में हमारी statement हमें learn हो जाएगी. Right? So we are saying angle subtended by an arc of a circle. सर्कल का आर्क जो एंगल सबटेंड करता है एट द सेंटर, सर्कल के सेंटर पे, ये सेंटर एंगल सबटेंडेड बाय एन आर्क ऑफ अ सर्कल. सो आई एम टेकिंग द आर्क पी क्यू एट द सेंटर. आई एम टेकिंग सेंटर एट द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल. कौन सा एंगल बना? पी ओ क्यू. ये जो एंगल है, सो आई एम राइटिंग पी ओ क्यू is, मतलब is equal to, is double the angle, that means two times. कौन सा angle? Double the angle subtended by it. It means same arc, subtended by the arc at a point on the remaining part of the circle. This word remaining part of the circle matters a lot here. Let me tell you how. So when I am taking this to be the minor arc, then remaining part of the circle, what is the remaining part of the circle? Is arc ne jo space circle ka gher liya, usko chhod ke whatever is left, that is the remaining part of the circle. This is the remaining part of the circle. Angle subtended by an arc at the center is double the angle subtended by the same arc at a point on the remaining part of the circle. Suppose I am taking a point, say arc, on the remaining part of the circle. आप लोगों के माइंड में ये क्वेश्चन आ सकता है, why R is to be taken here? R can be taken anywhere except the place PQ has occupied. PQ ने जो place occupy किया है, उसको छोड़ के R circle की boundary पे कहीं पे भी हो सकता है. I am taking it to be here. Angle subtended by same arc at the another point on the remaining part of the circle, that is PRQ. Two times angle here. अब स्टेटमेंट को लर्न करो. एंगल सबटेंडेड बाय एन आर्क ऑफ द सर्कल एट द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल इज डबल द एंगल सबटेंडेड बाय द सेम आर्क एट ए पॉइंट ऑन द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द सर्कल. एंगल सबटेंडेड बाय डैश आर्क ऑफ द सर्कल एट डैश एट द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल इज डैश डबल द एंगल सबटेंडेड बाय डैश मतलब इटसेल्फ एट ए पॉइंट डैश on the remaining part of the circle. When you relate this theorem, statement of this theorem with the figure, then very quickly you are able to tell the statement. So don't forget that only the proof of the theorem is related. Statement can be asked. जैसे last paper में आपसे पूछा गया था state midpoint theorem. So many intelligent बच्चों ने statement में गलती की. उनको लगा proof तो delete है, तो हम statement भी रहने देते हैं. Statement is not deleted. So statement can be asked in one mark. Angle subtended by an arc at the center of the circle is double the angle subtended by the same arc at a point of the remaining part of the circle. This is in the case of minor arc. Now, second case I am considering for the semicircular arc. Semicircular arc. When the arc is known as semicircular arc, if end point of the arc lies on the end point of diameter. For example, I am making the figure. This is center. This is diameter. Semicircle. This is a semicircular arc. This is a semicircular arc. Angle subtended by this semicircular arc at the center. मैंने ऊपर वाला सेमी सर्कल लिया, आप नीचे वाला भी ले सकते हो. एट द सेंटर दैट मींस POQ, सेंटर पे POQ बनाया. दिस इज डबल द एंगल सबटेंडेड बाय द सेम आर्क एट ए पॉइंट ऑन द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द सर्कल. रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द सर्कल इज दिस. लेट अस टेक आर टू बी हियर. दिस इज टू टाइम्स हियर. दैट मींस एप्लीकेशन इज सेम वेदर द माइनर आर्क और द सेमी सर्कुलर आर्क. There will be no difference. You will apply that center angle is double the circumferential angle. मतलब remaining part of the circle angle. Same चीजें हैं. Center का angle POQ. अगर आप ऊपर वाला semi circle ले रहे हो, ये this place has been occupied. You are left with this place. So this is double the angle made by the same arc at a point on the remaining part of the circle. So that point I am taking to be R. So the angle is becoming PR. Two times PR. Semicircular arc. Now the third case I am going to discuss, that is major arc, and there is a minor difference between the application. Let me tell you how. Third case is major arc. देखो बेटे ध्यान से देखो, ये मान लो सर्कल का सेंटर है. अगर हम दो पॉइंट नीचे लेते हैं तो माइनर आर्क बनता है. अगर यही दो पॉइंट सेमी सर्कल के डायमीटर के एंड पे हो जाते हैं तो सेमी सर्कुलर आर्क बनता है. और अगर हम यही दो पॉइंट सेंटर के ऊपर जाके ले लें तो ये जो आर्क बन जाता है पी क्यू, पी आर क्यू बोल दो आप, दिस इज अ मेजर आर्क. गुरपाल सिंह, फर्स्टली स्विच ऑन योर वीडियो ओनली, देन आई कैन इनवाइट यू टू आस्क योर क्वेरी. वीडियो ऑन करो, आपकी क्वेरी का आंसर किया जाएगा. अदरवाइज यू आर रेजिंग हैंड, फॉर मी इट हार्डली मैटर्स. चलो, सो दिस इज द मेजर आर्क ऑफ द सर्कल. This is the major arc of the circle. In this case, छोटे से difference के साथ इस theorem की application. Let us see what is this. If I ask you that what angle this major arc is making at the center, what will be your answer? What angle? मैं यहाँ पे T ले लेती हूँ. क्योंकि आर मैंने रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द सर्कल में लेना है, क्योंकि सेम रहेगा फिर. व्हाट एंगल दिस मेजर आर्क इज मेकिंग एट द सेंटर. एनीवन रेज योर हैंड. यस बच्चे, कम फॉरवर्ड, रेज योर हैंड. तुषार, एनीवन एल्स? मान्यावित, यस मान्यावित, यू टेल. वैसे तो आपको भी वीडियो ऑन करनी चाहिए, ओनली देन आई शुड इनवाइट यू. चलिए, टेल मी मान्यवित, व्हाट विल बी द एंगल दैट दिस मेजर आर्क विल डिस्क्राइब एट द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल.
reflex of angle POQ.
बिल्कुल ठीक. This time जो एंगल बेटे हमने देखना होता है ना वो आर्क जैसे ये आर्क उसमें इंक्लूड होनी चाहिए. अगर हम ये वाला एंगल कह देते हैं तो ये तो आर्क से बाहर का हो गया. हमारी आर्क तो इस हिस्से में है तो एंगल आर्क की साइड वाला लेना है. तो आर्क की साइड वाला ये जो एंगल है सेंटर पे दिस इज नॉट पीओक्यू दिस इज रिफ्लेक्स पीओक्यू. सो आई एम राइटिंग सेंटर पे जो इसने एंगल बनाया दैट इज रिफ्लेक्स एंगल पीओक्यू. बचा हुआ एरिया कौन सा है सर्कल का सर्कमफ्रेंस पे बाउंड्री पे ये वाला. इस पे पॉइंट आर लिया. अब इस पॉइंट आर पे इस आर्क का एंगल पी आर क्यू. दिस इज डबल द एंगल पी आर क्यू. दिस विल बी द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द थ्योरम इन केस ऑफ मेजर आर्क. दैट मीन्स इन रेस्ट ऑफ द टू आर्क्स दैट मीन्स इन द माइनर आर्क एंड इन द सेमी सर्कुलर आर्क द एप्लीकेशन विल बी सेम. दैट मीन्स angle at the center is double the angle at the circumference, but in case of major arc instead of having angle POQ that means center angle we will be having reflex angle POQ is 2 times PRQ. This is degree Meyer theorem in case of major arc. बाकी दोनों में simple angle and in major arc के केस में हमने reflex angle लिया. So once again I am repeating the statement angle subtended by dash that means arc of a circle at dash that means center is dash that means double of what angle subtended by it where at a point on the remaining part of the circle. Degree Meyer theorem very important theorem. Its application is there in exercise 10.5. So many times we will apply it in the extra questions also. So degree Meyer theorem, as the name suggests, its use is to measure the degree, that means to measure the angle in the particular figure, that is circle, right? Chaliye, this is all about degree Meyer theorem. Now I have to tell you some observations which are going to be very important. They are also called theorems itself, but we have to take them very seriously. Chaliye. वैसे तो ये थ्योरम नहीं दिया हुआ जस्ट एन ऑब्जर्वेशन है बट आई एम मार्किंग देम एज रिमार्क. रिमार्क वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Angles made by a chord in the same segment made by a chord in the same segment of a circle are equal. Very important. 10th में भी आपने इसको use करना है. जितने भी theorems हम कर रहे हैं इस सबकी सबका जो यूज है वो 10th में भी होना है. सो आपको बहुत अच्छे से इनको सीखना चाहिए. एंगल मेड बाय अ कोड इन द सेम सेगमेंट ऑफ ए सर्कल आर ऑलवेज इक्वल. इसको भी हम फिगर के थ्रू देखते हैं तो हमें ज्यादा समझ आएगा. लेट अस सी हाउ. सपोज आई एम मेकिंग अ सर्कल एंड आई एम टेकिंग इट्स वन ऑफ कोड PQ. दिस इज द सेंटर. Now, when I draw this chord of the circle, this circle is divided into two segments. One segment is on the lower part of the chord, another segment is on the upper part of the chord. And what he says, angle made by this chord in the same segment. ये वाला segment same हो गया. एक segment है ये जो कि chord ने divide किया. इस पे कोई दो points लो. Let us take it to be R and S. And if I want to see the angle of this chord PQ at this point R, very much obvious, this is PRQ. Or is this segment B, if I want to see the another angle made by this chord, then I can see that angle at S, this is PSQ. And according to this theorem, these two angles, they are going to be equal. Angle made by a chord in the same segment of the circle, they are going to be equal. This I am going to use so many times, so you have to remember this result. नहीं पता चल रहा किसी को पूछ लो. When you will relate this statement with the figure, then what obvious very easily you will grasp this theorem. No, I'm right, but making a remark too, and that is theorem 10.9. वैसे हम इसके proofs करवाते होते थे आगे, but अभी ज़रूरत नहीं है. Delete हो गए proof. आप result ही याद रखो. Remark two. Angle in the semicircle. Angle in the semicircle is a right angle. Angle in the semicircle is a right angle. Suppose you are having a circle and there is a diameter of the circle PQ and this is a point R and this PRQ. Now you can see that this PRQ, this is angle in the semicircle of the circle. Because when I draw the diameter, the upper portion or the lower portion both will be considered as semicircle. So PRQ is an angle which is in the semicircle. So what this theorem says that PRQ, this will always be 90 degrees. Angle in the semicircle is always a right angle. Angle in the semicircle is always a right angle. This is second thing that you will remember. बहुत सारी चीजें हैं. इस पहले तो देखो आप लोग तो फिर बचे हुए हो. पहले जो जो स्टूडेंट होते थे पिछले बैच के और उससे पिछले बैचेस के, दे आर टू डू द थ्योरम्स प्रूफ एज वेल. इतने थ्योरम्स जो मैं आपको बता रही हूँ, माइनर आर्क के केस में, मेजर आर्क के केस में, सेमी सर्कुलर आर्क के केस में, डिग्री में, ये थ्योरम का प्रूफ तीन तीन हो गए. दिस इज टू बी प्रूव्ड, दिस इज टू बी प्रूव्ड. सो यू आर टू जस्ट रिमेंबर द रिजल्ट, सो यू शुड इजिली रिमेंबर इट. सो द नेक्स्ट डेफिनेशन आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद साइक्लिक कोऑर्डिनेट. Cyclic quadrilateral. Cyclic quadrilateral. Quadrilateral we know very well. Types of quadrilateral we know very well. Parallelogram, square, rhombus, rectangle, and all that. But what is this cyclic quadrilateral? This is something new that we are going to learn. Cyclic circle se related hoga, name se pata chal raha hai. So figure se aapko definition pata chal jani chahiye that a quadrilateral whose vertices touches the circle is called cyclic quadrilateral. Quadrilateral whose vertices touches the circle is called cyclic quadrilateral. You have to remember this theorem. आपको याद रखनी है theorem statement that cyclic quadrilateral is that quadrilateral in which touches the whose vertices touches the circle like this. अगर ऐसे हो ये figure, फिर हम इसको जो है तब भी कह सकते हैं cyclic quadrilateral. But अगर ये figure ऐसे हो then it will not be known as cyclic quadrilateral because one vertex is there which is not touching the boundary of the circle. If all the vertices touches the boundary of the circle, only then it will be called cyclic quadrilateral. So now we will learn some theorem based on the cyclic quadrilateral which we will use in exercise 10.5. bahut sari cheeze ho gayi learn karne wali and whose utility is there in exercise 10.5. theorem 10.11, I'm just telling you the statement and its application with the help of figure. But theorem 10.11 says that sum of opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 डिग्री. सम ऑफ ऑपोजिट एंगल्स ऑफ ए साइक्लिक, आइदर पेयर ऑफ लिखना चाहिए मुझे, सम ऑफ इधर पेयर ऑफ ऑपोजिट एंगल, मतलब दो पेयर होते हैं ऑपोजिट एंगल के, दोनों में से किसी को भी ले लो आप, ये रिजल्ट होल्ड करेगा. सम ऑफ इधर पेयर ऑफ ऑपोजिट एंगल्स ऑफ ए साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलेटरल इज 180 डिग्री. यू कैन सी ऑन द बोर्ड these are the opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral, but this theorem says its sum will be 180. And moreover, these are also forming the opposite pair of you can say cyclic quadrilateral, so their sum will also be 180. Angle B plus C, this is equal to 180. So we will apply this theorem whenever we need to find some angles, and whenever suitability of this theorem's application will be there. Then come to theorem 10.12. Theorem 10.12. If sum of either pair of opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degree, then it will be a cyclic quadrilateral. If sum of either pair of opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degree, then it is a cyclic quadrilateral. This is converse of this theorem, that if this happens, then this will happen, and if this is there, then that will happen. That means if we are having sum of opposite angles to be 180 degree, then that quadrilateral is going to be a cyclic quadrilateral, right? So this is all about the theorem part of the chapter. So earlier we used to do the proofs of these theorems as well, but this time they are being deleted from the syllabus. You are lucky from this aspect. So you just have to remember the statements, and you just have to see that how we are going to apply this statement in the different questions. Right? चलिए यही हमारे theorems हैं जिनको हमें use करना है. Let us recall it once we did the degree Mayer theorem. Anyone who can speak the statement of degree Mayer theorem? Tushar. हाँ जी Tushar बोलो.
Angle subtended by an arc at the center of the circle is double the angle subtended by it at remaining part of circle.
Very good, Shabash. And this theorem is known as? Yes, Gurpal, this theorem is known as?
Degree Mayer theorem.
Degree Mayer theorem. And in case of major arc, there is little difference. Can you tell that difference? In case of major arc, there is a little difference in the application of the theorem. Can you tell that difference? Panji Georgia sisters.
Ma'am, angle subtended by the major arc of the circle is reflex of the angle subtended by the minor arc of the circle.
Right. Difference sirf itna hi hai that ki jahan pe hum माइनर आर्क और सेमी सर्कुलर आर्क के केस में सेंटर का एंगल सिंपल लिखते हैं, मेजर आर्क के केस में रिफ्लेक्स लिखेंगे. ओनली दिस डिफरेंस इज देयर, नो अदर डिफरेंस. यस दीपाली, यू अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ. दीपाली
यस मैम.
व्हाट इज साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलेटरल?
A quadrilateral whose vertices touches the circle is known as cyclic quadrilateral.
Can you tell me one property of a cyclic quadrilateral?
Sum of either pair of opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral is always 180 degree.
Very good. Sum of either pair of opposite angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is always 180 degree. Yes, Gaurav. Gaurav, unmute yourself. Kanish, you unmute yourself. Kanish Kareem. No. Manyavit.
Yes, ma'am.
Manyavit, what you can say about angles of a chord which it will be making in the same segment of the circle?
The angles made by a chord in the same segment of a circle are equal.
Are always equal. And what you can say about the angle in the semicircle?
Angles in the semicircle forms the right angle.
Angle in the semicircle is always right angle, that is 90 degree. Chaliye, let us start with exercise 10.5 based on these theorems. Question number first. First question. ABC are three points on the boundary of the circle. ABC are the three points on the boundary of the circle with center O. There is a point D of the circle like this. We are given angle AOB equal to 60 degree, angle BOC equal to 30 degree, and we want to find angle ADC. ADC angle aapko find karna hai. So, you know, when you are looking at this angle AD, then you can easily see that this is subtended by this minor arc. ये तो इधर रह गया ना, this अंदर की तरफ जो आप इसको अंदर की तरफ घेरेगा उससे ये subtend होगा. अंदर से इस एंगल को जो आर्क कवर कर रहा है वो आर्क है AC, and that is the minor arc of the circle. This ADC is the minor is the angle subtended by minor arc at the remaining part of the circle. यानी कि AC ने अपने हिस्से को छोड़ के सर्कल के जिस हिस्से पे एंगल डिस्क्राइब किया, that is ADC. और साथ ही साथ हमें एक सेंटर वाला एंगल देखना है. दो एंगल्स देखने हैं और डिग्री मेजर थ्योरम लगा देना है. व्हाट इज द एंगल मेड बाय दिस आर्क एसी एट द सेंटर, दैट इज एओसी. और हमें इन दोनों एंगल्स के बीच में डिग्री मेजर थ्योरम के थ्रू रिलेशन पता है. लेट अस स्टार्ट. कंसीडर माइनर आर्क, कंसीडर माइनर आर्क एसी ऑफ द सर्कल. Consider minor arc AC of the circle. So by sida likho, by degree measure theorem, not to state, sida hi likh doge chalega. By degree measure theorem, this angle is making arc angle AOC at the center. Angle subtended by the by an arc at the center AOC. This is double the angle subtended by same arc at a point on the remaining part of the circle. Remaining part of the circle pe angle D hai. तो कौन सा एंगल पॉइंट डी है, कौन सा एंगल बनाया, ए डी सी. टू टाइम्स एंगल ए डी सी. यू नीड टू एंगल्स, वन सेंटर वाला एंगल, दूसरा सबटेंडेड बाय द सेम आर्क एट द अनदर पॉइंट, राइट. व्हाट अबाउट एंगल एओसी, दिस इज कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ टू एंगल, एंगल एओबी प्लस एंगल बीओसी. दिस इज अ सम ऑफ टू एंगल्स, टू टाइम्स ए डी सी. What is AOB right here? This is 16. What is BOC? This is 30. This is 2 times angle ADC. So 60 plus 30, you can see it is 90. This is 90 equal to 2 times angle ADC. So 90 upon 2 is equal to ADC. So this is 45. This is the answer for ADC. After a very short time, we'll start with the next chapter. So have a break of 15 minutes. We'll meet shortly.